In this exercise, we'll once again take a look at how a few different transactions impact the basic accounting equation, assets equals liabilities plus equity. The first transaction says that the company received $35 from performing services. So to record this first transaction, we'll first need to remember that revenues can be recorded in an accrual-based system when they're earned, or in this case, when the service is performed. The fact that we also received the $35 on the spot impacts the transaction as well. So for this first transaction, we'll come down to cash, and we'll increase the cash account $35. Now this transaction is a little unique in the sense that we'll also need to impact the income statement by the same amount. So revenues increase $35 as well. Now, if you strictly look at the accounting equation here, in other words, since we've recorded two sides of the transaction, but if we look at the accounting equation, we're actually not in balance here because we've increased the asset side, but you notice the liabilities and equity side has not been impacted. This side of the equation is still out of balance. So in order to get this in balance, we're going to need to take a few extra steps. Ask yourself, what impact does increasing revenues have on the income statement as a whole? Well, if revenues increase, then net income also increases. So over here, we'll actually take and reflect that by increasing net income $35. Now, the last thing to remember is that when net income increases, what happens to net income at the end of the accounting period? Well, if you recall from your readings, what happens is we go through a closing process where net income is transferred to equity, specifically retained earnings. This closing process we haven't actually covered in detail yet, so you can just trust that it happens, but this net income gets transferred to equity at the end of the accounting period, and if we have an increase in net income, then likewise retained earnings would increase as a result of that transfer. So now if you focus on just the accounting equation as a whole, our assets increased and our equity increased via that transfer at the end of the close process. So this gets us back in balance. Now in terms of cash flow, when you perform services, this would be an operating activity, and specifically this would be a plus as you're getting cash, OA, operating activity. And this would also be an asset source as you received cash as a result of performing those services. The second transaction says we paid $10 to employees. This is a similar transaction to revenues, just in reverse. First, let's start with cash. In this case, cash actually went down, so we're going to take and indicate that by putting a minus $10 to cash. Now, on the income statement, when we pay employees wages, we pay those and recognize those expenses when they're incurred. And in this case, the payment and the incurrence of the expense happened at the same time. So expenses actually went up as a result. And much like the way we evaluated revenues, when expenses goes up, the impact on net income is actually a decrease. Revenues increase net income, and expenses actually decrease net income. So under the net income column here, we'll put that or indicate that with a minus 10. So expenses goes up, net income actually goes down. Now, just like with revenues, expenses are part of the closing process, the accounting period, and those expenses are transferred to retained earnings or equity. And the impact would be the same. So if you have a decrease to net income, you would have a decrease to retained earnings. And by indicating this on our form with a decrease of minus $10, you can see here now that since we have a decrease to assets and we have a decrease to equity, our basic accounting equation, this side of the form here, is now in balance. So all revenues and expenses are recorded in this manner.